Everyone, so really quick, this is a part two to a few more, not even solutions, but just some things that I think will help people search their core and answer these questions for themselves pertaining to all of the things surrounding soft life and that whole world, because like I said before, it goes by many names. So whatever you identify it as, the first thing I think I would like more women to do is throw the guilt out the damn window. Throw it out. Get rid of it, because we've got to stop bullying each other, policing each other, and we've got to stop feeling like it's wrong to want nice things. It's wrong to aspire to experience different things. It's wrong to want all the things that we know money can give us. We also understand that money is a tool, and tools, just like anything else, can be abused. So as long as you know in your heart, you check your heart, okay? You're searching your conscience. And whatever spiritual practices you have, you're praying, you're seeking, you're whatever, digging deep and knowing for yourself that, okay, this is my relationship with money and this is what I want. This is why I want it. Doesn't make you bad. You know what I mean? Okay. The third thing I think is important in this whole process of reshaping our thoughts and feelings and beliefs around this world is asking ourselves, where do we get our validation from? Because that's a biggie. We know those type of people that run around here and they buy the bags, they do all the things, they put everything on social media and show off excessively because they don't feel like they are enough. They don't know who they are. They need people to constantly see them and give them an applause, a thumbs up, a like, whatever. We're getting too old for that. Self-awareness, self-confidence, self-love, self-validation all come from within. It does not come when you get a certain salary or an allowance or a gift of money or an inheritance or your business is started and you're making money, okay? It does not come from getting into a new fancy, special, shiny, sparkly relationship. And he is the provider. He does spoil you. He is giving you the world. You don't have to work anymore. Or you've got the best of both worlds. You got your bag and he still provides. It's not about, you know, tying your identity to some kind of social milestone. Okay? If you see something and you want to experience it or you want to buy that thing or have that thing so you can feel important, there's something wrong with that. Okay? Buy things, experience things, enjoy things because that's what you want, whether people are looking or not. If Instagram and Facebook and YouTube crash tomorrow, because it can, are you still going to want to do these things? Are they still high up on your list as things that recharge you, the things that make you feel good, the things that make you feel like, okay, you are a kid again? I'll use myself for an example. I love to shop, yes. And I love quality bags. I also try to buy my bags from Black-owned or women-owned designers and businesses. Okay? So I don't have a Louis Vuitton. I don't have a Gucci bag. I don't have a Fendi bag. Now, if I got the opportunity to... Babe says, what do you want? And I see one that I really, really like. And it's, you know, then I might get it. But I find joy in things that are eclectic and handmade and have a story behind it. That's just me. I don't have to get on here and preach and scream and, again, make someone else feel bad because they have a Chanel collection. I don't care. If she loves it, if she likes it, I love it. Okay, so you see the difference in... okay, we can all love our handbags. We can all have, you know, a luxury collection. I consider my collection luxury. I have an F&W bag. That bag was $400. That was a gift for Mother's Day. I have a Brandon Blackwood bag. That bag was three something. I have a Love Courtney bag. It's like a little, whatever. Y'all see my review videos. Okay? So whether I go out and anyone says, oh, I know that bag. I love your bag. I don't care because I love my bag. So I don't need anyone to recognize or give me that moment. Knowing your authentic desires, know why you love shoes, you know, or not even why, but you know, just checking that. Because a lot of times some people are only motivated and inspired by, you know, oh, okay, they're going to know how much this costs. They're going to know how much I spent on this. I've got money because I spent the money. So just finding that balance. Giving back also feels good. Purging feels good. You know, giving things away feels good. I don't go far as minimalists, but there are some people that swear that less is more. Hey, find your niche. I am a maximalist at heart. I love all my stuff. I like seeing all my stuff together. But you know, my definition of collections and whatever looks very different than the next woman, and I'm okay with that. But finding your balance, you know, again, do you buy pre-loved, or do you buy vintage, or do you let's get away from tangible things. Let's do experiences. Do you like to support small businesses and small experiences and support up-and-coming chefs and go to establishments and events and venues that are a little bit more curated and intimate instead of like, oh, you went to Coachella or, oh, you went to, you know, some fancy fashion show in Paris or whatever. You know, it's bringing it back down and making it about you. We can't all be the same on a larger scale. That's not even realistic. But what we can do is step away from forums, podcasts, comment sections, Facebook posts, and in places where you're right, I'm wrong. You're materialistic, you're a consumer, you're shallow, you're a show off. You know what I mean? Last time I checked, we are all grown-ass women minding our own business, doing what works for us. And the only time I feel the need to not even correct another sister, another woman, but to in love say, consider this. Had you thought about that? Is when I see her. When I'm actively watching her self-sabotage, accept the least, working hard, not taking care of herself, entertaining deadbeat men, giving her money away, giving her energy away, not stepping into all of the greatness and the potential that she possesses. Just not, like, you don't even, like, my heart breaks when I see stories like that. When I see women say, okay, you know, it's my life, I do what I want. And you're like, I do too. I feel just as passionately, but yours is a little backwards because you're not prospering. You're not at peace. You're not good. This is not okay. You can do better. You can be better. You can have more if you chose yourself, if you raised the standard, if you took time for yourself. It's not okay for you to be, you know, run down like this. It's not okay for you to be so stressed out like this. It's not okay for you to be so anxious and broken and then on repeat and wondering what's wrong and how come you just can't get it together and your life is heading in this direction because you've got it on autopilot in the wrong direction. You date the same type of men. You think the same type of thoughts. You wear the same type of clothes. You exert the same type of low effort, afterthought kind of stuff, and it's not good. So yes, when I see women like that and I have an opportunity, like I did in New York this past holiday, we're in the bathroom. I accidentally walk in on her. The door didn't lock and we had a laugh about that. And she comes out and she just starts pouring out her story. And I'm like, okay, slow down, back up. So this guy's doing this, this guy's doing that. And she's like, yeah. And you know, I just wish guys were easy to understand. I said, you gotta dump him. You gotta dump him. But he's not even your main problem. You have to know that you deserve way better in every sense of the way. But anyway, this is about things that you can do to solidify you feeling like, okay, if you did want to step into your soft life, your soft girl era, soft girl season, your princess treatment era, you're stepping into your queendom, your main character energy and all the things. This is how you can think about it and not let anyone ruffle your feathers around what it is that it looks like you're doing. Because people are going to, maybe, depending on your circles, they're going to be like, where are you going all dressed up? What, you know, where are you going? What's going on today? And you'll be like, you can just simply tell them, me, I'm what's going on today, my day, my plans. Oh, I see you, you know, you, you know, coming back from another trip that you might have saved and budgeted for and moved some things around, or you were gifted that opportunity, that experience. You know, you don't owe anyone an explanation. You don't owe anyone an apology. You don't owe anyone any kind of like, well, this is why I feel like I blah, 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 blah. Especially if you're a mother. So we're getting away from that, bearing the load. We're stepping away from the muling. We're stepping away from carrying all of this shit that is not our responsibility. It's time for us, because when you put all that down, you can focus on what makes you feel good, what makes you feel happy, what makes you feel at ease and at peace. And we all know that money, gifts and provision and a new way of looking at money and using money allows you that. It's not bad and it's not wrong and it's not for you. it's not for you. But do you want to, you know, you decide when you jump in. It's like the little double dutch, you know, the strings is going, the game is going. When you going to jump in? Because it's ever turning. You know, these things are going on and nobody is at the end of the day going to come and tell you to leave. Excuse me, ma'am. You know, this isn't for you. I'm sorry. Whatever. So I just wanted to add that on to the end of the other conversation that I started. Thank you for not watching, but listening. Happy Saturday. Until the next one. Peace. Bye.